My name is Cheng Han Chen. I am a PhD candidate in bioengineering here at UCLA, and I work with the Ardehali Lab here. So heart disease itself is the number one killer here in the United States, and so I'm working on the disease called ischemic heart disease, basically what happens after you have a heart attack and all the damage that causes to the heart and to the rest of the body as well. So I'm developing new technology that will help deliver drugs specifically to target damaged area of the hearts to repair them. So I grew up in a neighborhood called Bayside. It's part of the borough of Queens in New York City. My parents don't have a science background at all. We were all immigrants from Taiwan, and when we came here and when I was growing up, they ran a small business. So I first began interested in science in high school. I think it was during our freshman biology class when I just started learning all about biology, and I pursued that in high school by working in laboratories. So I was very lucky. In New York City, there are many research universities and research laboratories, and I was able to join one and just start doing research then. So here in the lab, I work on a bioengineering aspect of treating heart disease. What I actually do is I work on creating and refining what we call nanoparticles. These are very specific type of therapy that we can use to deliver certain medications to the heart. I use a lot of different pieces of equipment for my research. A very common one I use is something called a fluorescence microscope. And so what that is a microscope, something that can look very closely at details in samples and see what's going on there. And you know, with this particular microscope, you can look at different colors, and depending how you set up the model you use for your experiment, you can figure out a lot of interesting things just based on color. Lab life involves a lot of collaboration between you and all your partners and the collaborators. Instead of just working by yourself on a problem, really, research problem nowadays require lots of different specialties, lots of different techniques, which not one person can really know. So really, you need a big team. My goal for this project is to come up with a new therapy to treat heart disease. Specifically, I'm hoping that this therapy that I come up with can actually limit a lot of the damage that happens when someone has a heart attack. And so if this works, I think it could make a really big impact in health in the world. I think the personality traits that make for a good scientist starts with curiosity. You have to be very interested in the world you live in and trying to understand how things work. So that's a very important one. I would encourage all young people to consider a career in research. I think it's one of the areas that you can go into that you can actually change the world with what you do.